Jessica Miraglia.
Thank you, Judge, and a huge, huge thank you to the team, the whole Luzerne team for inviting me here today to speak. Some of these members are still the same members that I know. As the judge introduced me, you probably wondered why I was here, why I'm speaking today. Let me tell you something that my outstanding resume and the judge didn't tell you. My name's Jessica, and I'm an addict. This past June, I celebrated 13 years sober, and it was because of this treatment court program. I was one of the first graduates of the treatment court. In June of 2006, they held, or in 2007, they held the first treatment court graduation, and I was among those people. I wanted to start off by showing you something that's very special to me. This is the certificate of excellence I received the day I graduated from the treatment court. And there's 12 of them here. 12 people in this room are about to receive one of these. And I hope you still have it 13 years later. On top of that, I brought something else very important to me. When I was arrested, I landed myself on the front page of the newspaper. There I am. Today, landed myself on the front page of the newspaper. The treatment court encouraged me to go to college, so I did, not knowing what I wanted to do. but I have experience in criminal justice. So there I went. I got my associates in criminal justice because they forced me to. They knew I could do it. I wouldn't have done that without this team. I never would have gone to college. So, 2008, I graduate with my first degree. I get my associates in criminal justice, and I also have my daughter in 2008. I take about 2 years off to raise my daughter. I go back to college. Not because the treatment court team made me this time. They're done, I graduated. But it gave me the tools I needed, and they gave me that toolbox. So I knew what the next step needed to be. I did that on my own. I went back to college. I got my bachelor's degree in criminal justice. Still had no clue what I was going to do with my life. I also had criminal history, so what can I do is the fear. It's funny, when you go off to college right out of high school, they say you find out who you are. You do as an adult. I got to find out who I was. The defense attorney I told you about earlier, who fought to get me into this program, he didn't stop. He never stopped supporting me and believing in me. He continued to support me and gave me an internship both here in the Luzerne County Solicitor's Office and in his private office at DeLuca Law Offices. It was that summer, 2012, when I received that internship that I fell in love with legal studies. But me, a lawyer? Here I am. My background and passion in criminal justice kind of made the future inevitable, but I still didn't know it at the time. I start college at Widener's Law School. I commute 3 to 4 nights a week from here. Still interning during the day and working, and a single mom. I begin my internship at the Public Defender's Office here in Luzerne County. That's when it all clicks. That's when I realize what I'm going to do with the rest of my life. I vow to make a difference because my defense attorney made a difference in my life. And if he didn't fight for me, I wouldn't be here today. So if I can have one client that I changed their life, my overworked and underpaid career would be well worth it. I know I have one client in this program right now. She told me today she is a year clean today. I am so happy to hear that. I saw her walking down the street, actually, once, and stopped my car in the middle of the street to get out and hug this girl. I'm so proud to see how good she's doing. After my internship with the Public Defender's Office, I then got to intern with the very honorable Joseph Skwarowski. When I went to him for this internship, I was terrified. I was scared to tell him why I wanted to intern with him. Him particularly, because he's the treatment court judge. And judge, I was in treatment court. Wasn't sure how that conversation was going to happen. And it was a complete opposite reaction of what I expected. He was proud of me. He couldn't wait to bring me on. And I got to spend that semester on the other side of the treatment court. Not only have I sat where you are in those seats, but I've got to sit in the room with these people while they make the decisions, where they do their magic behind those closed doors. And when I was in treatment court, I thought they were awful. They wanted me to do so many things. How can I possibly do all this? And then I sat in that room, and I realized they are truly, truly doing this because they believe in you and they care about you. That's it. They're not doing this to give you a hard time. They want you to succeed. And seeing that made me realize how great this program is. Because they're not doing this because it's their job. They're doing this because they love it. December of 2016, I graduate law school. But due to my criminal history, then going back 10 years, they wouldn't certify me except for the bar exam. They wouldn't give me my diploma. I fought it, of course. February 2nd, just 3 weeks before the bar exam, I find out they're going to give me my diploma. bar prep would be about an 8-week course. 3 weeks I did what I could and I sat for the bar exam. I failed. Can't take the bar exam until July of 2017. July comes, take the bar exam. October comes, I pass the bar exam. Probably one of the best days of your life when you have sat for that test. But I get the letter. Congratulations, passed. You spent 8 years in college. You spent $300,000 in loans. Or not going to give you your license. You're not good moral character and fitness, Jessica Miraglia. I didn't fight. I didn't give up. I kept fighting. I appealed that decision. And on January 22nd, 2018, I got licensed in the state of Pennsylvania to practice law. Today, I'm a criminal defense attorney who's representing indigent defendants who could not otherwise afford counsel on their own. My message here is twofold. One, it's for society, legislators, and prosecutors. I want you to hear my story and know the importance of the diversionary programs. We wouldn't be here today without programs like this. I wouldn't be here today if Bob O'Hara or Dave Pedry, who were prosecuting me at the time, didn't give me the chance to come into this program. Sometimes treatment and rehabilitation need to be put ahead of punishment. Kamala Harris says, to be smart on crime, we should not be in a position of constantly reacting to crime after it happens. We should be looking at preventing crime before it happens. For the first time, the numbers are real. I've always been a statistic on that piece of paper that was read at a treatment court graduation. We all are. But here we are. We're not numbers, we're people. We're humans, and we're humans that make mistakes. Yes, our mistakes rose to crime, but they were mistakes. To those that are in the program, that are graduating the program, and to those that have already graduated the program, the road to redemption is filled with failure. You are going to fail more than you are going to succeed. But it's not what you do when you fail. It's what you do after you fail. Do you climb back up? I sat there where you are. I had the same doubts. Would I ever be able to do this? My first week, would I make it another week? The last day when I was about to graduate, even scarier. Will I make it on my own? Anyone can give up. It's the easy thing to do. But when you hold it together, everybody expects you to fail. That's true strength. You will make it. You will succeed. Because treatment court prepared you exactly for that. Your toolbox is full. And don't lose track of what you're capable of and the life you really do deserve. And the life the loved ones around you deserve. Today is August 30th, 2019. 12 of you are graduating. You already know the best days are ahead of you. But the movie starts when the guy gets sober. That's never the end. Thank you.